Hello students, I hope that everyone is fine. So today we are going to start with discussing some of the question answers from the first lesson, that is the periodic classification of elements. Now the questions which I'm going to discuss today is just an indicative that how questions are asked in the, or which type of questions are asked in the board examination. Let's discuss the first question. Name the following: an alkali metal in period 3 and halogen in period 2. Now when I say alkali metal, please remember group number 1 elements are called as alkali metals, whereas group number 17 elements are known as halogens. So here the question which is asked is on group number 1 and group number 17. The first part is an alkali metal in period 3. Now period 1 has 1 shell, period 2 has 2 shell, and period 3 has 3 shell. So the 3 shell will be K, L, M, N. In K you have 2 electrons, in L you have 8 electrons, in M you will have only 1 electron because group 1 elements have 1 electron in their valence shell. So if you add the total, it becomes 11, and 11 is the atomic number of sodium. So answer for your first part is sodium. Now and halogen in period 2. Now period 2 has 2 cells, K, L, and halogens have 7 electrons in a valence cell. So 2 plus 7 is 9, and 9 is the atomic number of fluorine. So in short, answer is sodium and fluorine. Second question is the noble gas with 3 cell. Now noble gases belong to group number 18. 3 cells means period number 3. So we'll have 2 electrons in the first cell, 8 electrons in the second cell, and 8 electrons in the third cell. If you add the total, it's 18, and 18 is the atomic number of argon. The element of period 3 with valency 4. Now as it belongs to period 3, it will have K, L, M shell. In K shell you will have 2 electrons, in L shell you will have 8 electrons, in an M shell you will have 4 electrons because the valency of this element is 4. If you add the total, it's come to 14, and 14 is the atomic number of silicon. So answer would be silicon. I hope that you are able to understand how to derive the answer from the given information. Element in period 3 which does not form an oxide. Now period 3, please remember, period 3 is the period which starts with sodium, magnesium, then aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, and chlorine, argon. Now here if you see, sodium forms sodium oxide, magnesium forms magnesium oxide, aluminium forms aluminium oxide, silicon forms silicon oxide. Phosphorus forms either phosphorus trioxide or phosphorus pentoxide. Chlorine is the halogen which does not form oxide. Now in the sixth question, the element of lower nuclear charge out of beryllium and magnesium. Now if you look at the atomic number of beryllium, it is 4, and that of magnesium is 12. If you write the electronic configuration of beryllium, it is 2-2, and that of magnesium is 2-8-2. Now magnesium will have lower nuclear charge because it has 3 cells, and beryllium will have higher nuclear charge because it has 2 cells. Now if you remember, what is nuclear charge? The force of attraction exerted by the nucleus on the outermost electron is called as nuclear charge. So as beryllium has a smaller atomic radii, its nuclear charge will be more. Whereas in case of magnesium, as you have 3 cells, the nuclear charge will be less. Which has high electron affinity, fluorine or neon? If you remember, in the lecture we have discussed, electron affinity is the tendency of an atom to gain electron by the exchange of energy. Now if you look at fluorine and neon, fluorine has atomic number 9 electronic configuration to 7. Whereas in case of neon, electronic configuration is 2-8. As in case of neon, the outermost cell is filled with 8 electrons. That means it has octet. Therefore, neon will have lower electron affinity. Thus, your answer would be fluorine. Because fluorine has 7 electrons, it requires only 1 electron to complete its octet. Therefore, fluorine is having higher electron affinity than neon, which has maximum metallic character. Sodium, lithium or potassium. Now you can see all of these are metals, but lithium belongs to period number 2, whereas sodium belongs to period number 3, and potassium also belongs to period number 3. Now lithium electronic configuration 3, sodium electronic configuration 281 with atomic number 11, potassium atomic number 19, electronic configuration 2881. Now we can clearly see here that potassium has 4 cells. Sodium has 3 cells and lithium has 2 cells. Thus, the atomic radii of potassium is highest, then sodium and then lithium. So tendency to lose electron will be more in case of potassium. So potassium is more metallic. Please remember, metallic character means tendency to lose electron. I hope that everyone was writing out down the answers so that you can go ahead and learn it when the lecture is over. Let's discuss the next question. Now here again, before proceeding, let me tell you, you have to keep on revising the trends of elements in the periodic table. What happens when you are going from top to bottom and when we are moving from left to right? If you go through my previous lecture, I have discussed when you move from top to bottom, atomic radii increases, atomic size increases, metallic character increases, non-metallic character decreases, ionization energy decreases, electron affinity decreases, electron negativity decreases. You have to keep this in mind. And vice versa is applicable for your left to right, that is across a period. When you are moving from left to right, atomic size decreases, atomic radii decreases, metallic character decreases, non-metallic character increases, ionization energy increases, electron affinity increases, electronegativity increases. The reason is, when you are moving from left to right, effective nuclear charge increases due to the increase in electron-proton ratio. That means the number of electrons and protons increases when you are moving from left to right. Also remember, the number of cells remains the same. Now let's look at the first question. Arrange the following as per instruction given in the bracket. The elements are magnesium, chlorine, sodium, sulfur, silicon. Now if I look at these elements very carefully, I can come to know that these belongs to period number 3. And as we are new to these type of question, please write down the electronic configuration of all the elements so that you can remember and you can arrange them in the proper order. Now if you see, you have sodium atomic number 11, magnesium atomic number 12, silicon atomic number 14, sulfur atomic number 16 and chlorine atomic number 17, and their electronic configuration would be sodium 281, magnesium 282, sulfur 286, silicon 284 and chlorine 287. Now increasing order of atomic size, that means smallest should be first and the biggest should be at the last. So the smallest will be chlorine, because in chlorine effective nuclear charge is highest, because it has 7 electrons in the 17 electrons and 17 protons. Then would be sulfur with 16 protons and 16 electrons. Then would be silicon with 14 electrons and 14 protons. Then would be magnesium with 12 electrons, 12 protons. And then the last would be sodium the atomic size of sodium will be greatest in this case, because atomic size decreases when you are moving from left to right. If you even arrange the elements in the order of atomic numbers, you can clearly get sodium, atomic number 11, will be the highest atomic size. Then magnesium would be smaller than sodium. Silicon would be smaller than magnesium. Sulfur would be smaller than silicon. And chlorine would be smaller than sulfur. So this question can be resolved on the basis of atomic number itself. You don't have to go in depth, but I explained to you in depth so that you can apply the concept if you are confused in case of atomic number, or you are not, if you are not able to go ahead and recall the atomic numbers properly. If you are not sure, you can check it with the electronic configuration also. In the earlier class, I had given you homework to learn the atomic number of first 30 elements, because mostly they are going to ask you question based on the first 30 elements. Now the next question is, they have given the element name as cesium, sodium, lithium, potassium, rubidium. Increasing metallic character. If you look at these elements, all these elements belong to group number 1. Now either they will give you a group or they will give you a period. Then you have to apply your knowledge in that particular concept. Now when you move from top to bottom, metallic character increases. So we have to arrange these elements in the number of their cells. Like lithium has 2 cells, sodium has 3 cells, potassium has 4 cells, rubidium has 5 cells, and cesium has 6 cells. As the number of cells increases, the effective nuclear charge decreases, and thus metallic character increases, because metallic character is tendency to lose electron. So your lowest metallic element will be lithium, then sodium, then potassium, then rubidium, and at the end cesium. Now increasing ionization potential. The elements are sodium, potassium, chlorine, sulfur, silicon. Now ionization potential will be more where the effective nuclear charge is more. And all these elements, again, sodium, chlorine, sulfur, silicon, they belong to period number 3, but potassium belongs to period number 4. So potassium will come first because it has electronic configuration 2881, and as it has 4 cells, therefore tendency to lose electron is more as compared to the other elements. So therefore potassium will come first. Then we'll have sodium with atomic number 11, that is 11 electrons and 11 protons. Then will be silicon with 14 electrons and 14 protons. Then will be sulfur with 16 electrons and 16 protons. And the element having highest ionization potential in this particular question would be chlorine with 17 electrons and 17 protons. Just to recall, we have done the definition of ionization potential in the last lecture. Ionization potential is the amount of energy required to donate the most loosely bounded electron from an isolated gaseous atom. So bigger the atom, easier it will be to donate or lose the electron. So chlorine will have highest ionization potential. The next question is increasing electron affinity. Now if you look at the elements, they are chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine. If you want to solve this question, you can arrange the elements in sequence so that the concept becomes more clear. You can arrange them in sequence in order of either atomic number or the number of cells. It depends on the question which is being asked. For example, in this question, I know that all these 4 elements belong to group number 17 and they are from the same group. Fluorine has atomic number 9, chlorine has atomic number 17, bromine 35 and iodine 53. Now electron affinity depends upon the size of an atom as well as effective nuclear charge. If you look, fluorine will have higher effective nuclear charge, then will be chlorine, then bromine, then iodine, because fluorine has 2 cells, chlorine has 3 cells, bromine has 4 cells, and iodine has 5 cells. So electron affinity will be more in case of small elements than in case of bigger elements. So your answer would be fluorine, then chlorine, then bromine and iodine. Last part of this question, it would be, E part, that is cesium, sodium, lithium, potassium, rubidium, decreasing electronegativity. That means electronegativity should be lowest at the end and highest at the beginning. You have the elements as cesium, sodium, lithium, potassium, rubidium. Now, lithium has three cells. Lithium has two cells with atomic number 3, electronic configuration 2-1. Sodium has three cells with atomic number 11, electronic configuration 2-8-1. Potassium has four cells with atomic number 19 and electronic configuration 2-8-8-1. Similarly, rubidium has atomic number 37 and cesium has atomic number 55. Now, electronegativity decreases when you are moving from top to bottom. So, first will be cesium, then rubidium, then potassium, sodium, and at the end, lithium. Because electronegativity decreases from top to bottom. Now let's look at a different question. Again, this is again a board question which has been asked in the board in the previous year. The question is, the element of one short period of the periodic table are given below in order from left to right. Let's look at the element to decide the period number. It is lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, oxygen, fluorine, neon. Somewhat it is given the sequence because lithium atomic number 3, beryllium atomic number 4, boron atomic number 5, carbon atomic number 6, oxygen atomic number 8, fluorine atomic number 9 and neon atomic number 10. And all these elements have two cell. Your electronic configuration of lithium will be 2-1, beryllium will be 2-2, boron will be 2-3, carbon will be 2-4, oxygen will be 2-6, fluorine will be 2-7 and neon will be 2-8. The first question asked from this table is, to which period do these elements belong? Now these elements belong to period number 2 because period number indicates the number of cell and group number indicates the number of valence electron. So here, as all these elements has two cells, therefore they belong to period number 2. One of the element from this period is missing. Which is the missing element and where should it be placed? When I was reading out the atomic number of these elements, if you were attentive at that point of time, you could have clearly seen I missed out atomic number 7. I said lithium 3, beryllium 4, boron 5, carbon 6, oxygen 8. That means I missed out the number 7. And the element with atomic number 7 is nitrogen. So our sequence is complete. And the element should be placed in between carbon and oxygen. So the question was, one element of this period is missing. Which is the missing element and where it should be placed? The missing element is nitrogen and it should be placed between carbon and oxygen. Place the three elements, fluorine, beryllium and nitrogen, in order of increasing electronegativity. Now your sequence would be beryllium, then nitrogen and then fluorine. Because beryllium has atomic number 4 with electronic configuration 2-2. Nitrogen atomic number 7, electronic configuration 2-5. Fluorine atomic number 9, electronic configuration 2-7. So fluorine will be more electronegative because it requires one electron to complete its octet. So first would be fluorine, then nitrogen, because nitrogen requires only 3 electrons to complete its octet, whereas beryllium requires 2 electrons to be donated to complete its doublet. Which of the above element belongs to halogen series? Now halogens are those elements or salt forming compounds and they belong to group number 17. If you look at the electronic configuration, fluorine, atomic number 9, electronic configuration will be 2-7. And the elements which have 7 electrons in their valence shells are placed in group number 17, that is halogen series. So answer is fluorine. Let's look at this question. This question was asked in 2010, again in the board examination. The number of electrons in the valence shell of hydrogen is A is 1, B 3, C 5, D 7. The answer would be 7, because halogens have 7 electrons in their valence shell and they are placed in group number 17. Non-metallic character down the group increases or decreases? Down the group, non-metallic character decreases because metallic character increases. We have done this. What is non-metallic character? Tendency to gain electron. And as you are moving down a group, what happens is that atomic size increases, atomic radii increases, effective nuclear charge decreases. Thus, metallic character increases and non-metallic character decreases. Atomic number of an element is... Now, atomic number indicates the number of protons or number of electrons in an atom. So, your answer would be either number of electrons or would be number of protons. So, the question asked is, from this information is, to which period it belong? Now, you can see, as atomic number is 16, so electronic configuration will be 286. Students, please do not try to specify the name of the element because that is not asked. So if it is not asked, or if it is given in the form of X and Y, you have to answer the question in the form of X and Y only. Because if they say element is X having atomic number 16, so your answer should be in the form of X only. So to which period it belongs? As it has three shells, it occupies three shells. You can check from the electronic configuration 286. Therefore, it belongs to period number 3. The number of valence electrons in the element. Now they are asking you about the valence electron. Do not get confused with valency. Valence electrons means number of electrons present in the outermost shell. Now when we were writing the electronic configuration, we can clearly see it is 286. Therefore, there are 6 electrons in the valence shell. The total, the element metal or non-metal. Is the element metal or non-metal? Now the element will be non-metal because it will accept 2 electrons and complete its octet. Acceptance of electrons is done by non-metal. That's the most simplest way to think of the answer. Next question, which was asked in 2018. In period 3 of periodic table, element B is placed to the left of element A. That means element B is on the left hand side of A. On the basis of this information, choose the correct word from bracket to complete the following statement. The element B would have lower or higher metallic character than A. Now, A is placed on the right hand side, whereas B is placed on the left hand side. The elements which are on the left hand side are more metallic as compared to the elements on the right hand side. Why? Because we have seen in the periodic table, metals are placed on the left hand side, whereas non-metals are placed on the right hand side. And as A is placed on the left hand side of B, therefore the element B would have lower metallic character than A. The element A would probably have lesser or higher electron affinity than B. The element A would have lesser electron affinity because A is metallic and B is non-metallic. The element A would have greater or smaller atomic size than B. If you are comparing A and B, A is placed on the right hand side. So it will have more electron affinity, more ionization potential and lower atomic radii because of more effective nuclear charge. Therefore, the element A would have smaller atomic size than B. Sorry. Yes. Atomic size of A would be smaller than B. So guys, we have done some question answers. You can refer the textbook and try to solve more question answers from it. Thank you and have a great day.